Come to you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. When you first look at these three readings, there really isn't any common theme, at least that I could find initially upon reading them. But as I read them intentionally, line by line, a theme appeared. But we can always look to the collect for some clues. The collect reads, "You alone can bring into order the unruly wills, and grant your people grace to love what you command and desire what you promise." And it goes on to talk about the weary changes of the world, and our hearts will find joy when we engage in activities that please God. Today's world is fast and furious. Life moves on at great speeds, and often it's hard to take notice of what really is important. Even when life is going smoothly, like the day I had on a Friday, it was a glorious sunny day. Didn't have any cares in the world, and I fully enjoyed this day. Nothing could possibly go wrong. But that's not how life works. And that's not how life worked for the 33 individuals who were displaced by an apartment complex fire on Monday of last week. You may have heard about this fire in the news. The apartment was near the UNC campus, and I heard it through Stacy. The American Red Cross called the churches in town. They happened to call her church where she works, and she told them, "Yes, you'll pass the word on." They were looking to try and house for a temporary shelter, 33 people. And she said, "You know what? My wife is meeting with all the Episcopal priests in town right now at Holy Cross having lunch. I'll pass that message on to them too." And so I get this call, and I text back, "In a meeting." And then ding, 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 you know, text after text starts coming in, and I realize that this is something I need to share with my colleagues. The American Red Cross, during the course of a couple hours or two, where there were repeated texts and emails between them and me, were able to find housing for these displaced individuals. Even one apartment complex took in five families. As soon as the meeting was over, I sent out an email to the interfaith and religious group that I belong to, 55 emails of different faith tradition ministers and rabbis and priests, and I asked them, can you help? And no sooner had I sent that email did I receive an email back from one of the rabbis in town. "I have money. Who do I send it to? Where do I go?" In the meantime, I had contacted my wardens and said, "Do you think we could house people? Do you think we could support this group?" Not knowing in that moment that the Red Cross had stabilized their homes and their housing for the night. But as that word became more and more, I became more and more aware of that, I realized our need now needed to change from housing folks to what can we do to help them out. And so you may have seen those email that I sent out this last Thursday and Friday. And it was wonderful on Friday for Betty and I to spend an hour trolling the aisles of PetSmart up the road here, buying pet supplies. And that's my car full, and the back too. I didn't take a picture of the back. And that's Betty and I and the manager, Colleen. We spent about $700, of which PetSmart gave us about $200 in discounts. So it came out to a little over $500. Now you might be asking, how does the story of helping others in our community relate to the readings today? The Lord says to the Israelites through the prophet Jeremiah, there is a covenant that has been made, and it's not going to be like the Ten Commandments I made before with your ancestors. It's going to be different. And I will write those commands on their hearts. And I will be their God, and they will be my people. And I have this image of God's hand with a quill ink pen writing on our hearts. Think about that. The colic reads, God wants us to reign in our unruly hearts, and God wants us to respond out of love. And then the gospel reads, whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant also be. We are to respond with love to those who in the swift and varied changes of this world, those curveballs, we are to walk alongside of. When Stacy and I went to deliver these supplies at the designated location, it was at the apartment complex where the five families were. We were talking at that time to a person by the name of Robin. Now, Robin is not affiliated with the Red Cross. She may be now, but she's not at the time. And so we get to the waiting on her in the parking lot, and out she jumps, and with her wife, we talk and we realize this is community. This is community building. Because Robin tells us their story. She and her wife were displaced during Hurricane Florence, had nothing. And this is what they do in life. This is their mission. They give back to the community. They came up with the list of things that people needed by looking at social media networks to find out what people were posting. And then finding that designated spot where those families can go and pick up supplies. That's what they're being called to do. So Stacy and I dropped off all the pet supplies. Robin came with food. But the message of today's readings is this. The first responders showed up. The Red Cross showed up. The faith communities showed up. Betty and I showed up. Holy Cross showed up with the support of funds. Other civic organizations showed up. And PetSmart showed up because they've decided to have a drive to support these families ongoing so they have pet supplies for the next month. All these people showed up. Each and every one of them. And we showed up because we followed Jesus' command. And we built a new community based on love. With God, all things are possible. Amen.